So the awesome thing about Switzerland is that you can get up. It's early right now. It's like 7:30. Sun is just trying to creep up over here. And you can wake up and say, let's go to Italy to go skiing. Just going across the border here into Italy. The sun is out and it is going to be a glorious day of skiing.
In the front, your foot, what is it?
It's touched.
Touch it?
Yeah.
And then good.
Now?
Now it's good.
It's good.
Yeah.
Good. 330 centimeters powder.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Wow. Very, very powder.
Yeah.
Yes. It's different than the snow.
Yeah.
The Northern California.
Yeah.
Very, very powder. It's very soft.
Yeah.
We are in Mont Blanc. And this is the second gondola. I don't know how much perspective we're picking up there on the camera, but it is beautiful out here. And there is snow everywhere, which is awesome. All right, first run done for the day. That was awesome. That was a little steep coming down. Where is it? Shit, it's all the way back up there. That was a steep one. So we're in Italy right now. This is the Alpine Telecabin Q&A. Okay, we're gonna do the fastest Telecabin Q&A before we get to the bottom down there. Had a bunch of questions. Don't have them right in front of me, but I think I can remember enough to do a Q&A. So, first question comes about my strings. What strings do I use on the bass? For the most part, on my Federa, for 98% of my playing, I use Jim Dunlop Super Bright Steels. The gauges are 105, 85, 65, 45, and the C string is 32. And then I just started using the Jim Dunlop flat wounds on one of my P basses, which are awesome. And there are some other things I've used over time, some stuff, really random stuff, nylon tape wound strings and copper wound strings and half wound, all these kind of things for different sounds, different things. But for the most part, it's the Jim Dunlop Super Bright Steels. Can't believe I'm still getting the same question about the baby elephant sound. What is it? How do I make the bass sound like a guitar, the double octave thing? PS5, I need to frant a bit. Maybe I'm gonna stop. I won't answer that question for at least 3 months now. How about that? Because that's on, you can just go watch the pedal vlog over again and I explain the whole thing there. Next question. How do I have the energy to do what I do, to do the vlog, to practice, to be where I am right now on the mountain skiing, to play tennis, to do all those things? It's pretty simple. Sleep is very consistent and very, very efficient, I would say. So I would say I get 6 hours sleep a night, which leaves 18 hours during the day to do stuff. And you'll be amazed at what you can get done in 18 hours if you really put your mind to it and don't waste time. So I think not wasting time is a huge key. I think that's been a massive part of my productivity and of any success I've had, and kind of productivity has been not wasting time. I get up and I really go for it. As you can see in the blog, you can kind of tell from the vlog my day and how it's laid out. Just need to make sure we're not getting into the station here with the telecabin or the gondola or the cable car or if I forget. All right, I said it was going to be a quick Q&A. It is, because we are getting into the station. Station is coming up right here. And I have to get my skis, my poles, my gloves, and myself out of this thing before the doors close again. All right.